Arizona. I'm Dr. Heather Kogodevich, and this is our family dog, Dexter. And we would like to invite you to come with us on a wonderful adventure to teach children how to produce their own organic food, their own clean water, their own renewable energy, and ultimately their own solar adobe housing to be used in the form of a classroom where they can share these skills with other children. Now, about the children and about these films, I want you to know that these are not slick, these are home movies, that the children themselves, and I think this is really amazing, the kids, preschool, grade school, high school, and college students, did this whole thing. They built all these systems, they did all the filming, they did all the editing, just produced and put together this whole really wonderful set of 33 lessons for you. The first, we start out with an introduction in the beginning, and it's kind of slow with the introduction. You realize that you have to build a garden to begin with, and then we break it down in step by step by step how you do all these lessons. And then at the very end, we have a little summary, and then there are three interviews at the very end with really important global humanitarian figures. The mother of holistic medicine, Dr. Gladys McGarry, Barbara Kerr, who invented the solar box cooker, and Professor Roy McAllister, engineer, who is dealing with the solar hydrogen civilization. These are important videos I think you'd like to share with your family and friends also. So I want you to know that these films, like I said, they're not slick, they're home movies, but they're wonderful. You're going to fall in love with the kids by the time the whole thing is over. The kids are kids. They're rowdy, they're muddy, they're funny, they're all the wonderful things that kids are. And that's how education is. It's just, it's education for real life. And in particular, these lessons that are so very, very important and need to be shared with I feel every school, the kids are doing it themselves, and you're going to really love the kids. So, again, we invite you to share with us as we go on this journey together, to learn these skills yourself, to share them with other people, and then for us all to be doing our part, to be educating our children the best possible way that we can, and to be helping to protect our whole beautiful Mother Earth. Thank you so much. So let us now begin to look at where the lessons will take us and be introduced to the children who work to build the systems. This series of teacher and student training lessons is dedicated to the hopes and to the prayers of families everywhere for the survival and flourishing of our children. These interlocking lessons use a collective wisdom of many to recycle renewable resources to help support us in the health and beauty of our Earth's environment. The lessons are based on the principle of using nature as a model to do more with less, seeking simple and affordable solutions to our common needs for food, water, energy, and housing. They also emphasize the balanced and healthy education of our children's bodies, minds, characters, and spirits, all done with a sense of responsibility and fun. Projects, filming, and editing were produced by elementary, teen, and college students with their teachers and families as part of their win-win education initiatives. So please be patient with any of our amateur but educational mistakes. We thank all of our teachers, parents, and grandparents for their work and sacrifice. We love all of you, and we love our Earth. Our mission statement. Educational mission to train teachers to serve children with four skill sets which promote 1, poverty alleviation, 2, environmental relief, 3, holistic health, 4, character development, by building sustainable environment education demonstrations which produce 1, organic food, 2, clean water, 3, renewable energy, and 4, affordable green housing. Our global seed lessons encourage and support secondary and college students to work with and to teach
younger students of all ages. There are three lesson levels. Number one, this basic garden series. Number two, future outdoor systems. And number three, future indoor systems. Level two and three lessons are being built, filmed, and edited by students for distribution in the near future. Level one is biointensive garden and pest control, compost system and worm farm, small animal husbandry and barn, harvesting, seed collection, and medicinal herbs, natural water purification pond, solar cooking and water purification. Level two in the future is household scale greenhouse, household scale fish farm, adobe oven and wind energy, methane energy production, top bar beehive. And number three, affordable alternative green housing such as solar, adobe, straw, rammed earth, etc. Food preparation, preservation, and storage. You can see that all of these are so important. The environmental challenges we face are very, very, very serious. But the good news is that we can use nature as a model to reverse the damage we've accidentally inflicted on our environment. Because if we start with the children, all else will fall into place. This is where our solutions are. And our solution is education, because education with love is the key. So let's roll up our sleeves and start working, since our children are the hope for the future of our garden planet. So we teach hands-on solutions to our common needs for food, water, and energy. Thus, all of our lessons are designed for learning skills that can save lives. And we strive to do all of this in a positive environment with beauty, creativity, and joy. Now let's look at a short overview of the skills our children are learning and enjoying. Claudia, you're so sweet. I'm going to move through all five of the systems mentioned earlier. Starting out with our student gardening tools. Here our family generation is building the beds from grandpas to preschoolers. Here we're doing double digging for a new bed. Here we have sprouted plants for a new garden. We have companion planting for pest control, and there are seeds interspersed. We're watering our new garden. Here's one of our finished garden areas with sunflowers and flowers. We're building compost area along the fence. See the girl in the back? We had so much fun watering our garden and taking care of everything. And now it's time to harvest, and here's a summer squash. And later on, here are the children collecting seeds. Here's this, look how intent this student is on studying seeds. And he collected flower seeds from her garden. Here the children are grinding wheat grains for flour. And here they're screening compost into small pieces so you can return it to the garden. And they're making a worm farm for Willy the Worm. She's searching in the garden for earthworms. So animal husbandry, we have goats and chickens. Here we're building an inexpensive chicken coop and our class on chicken physiology. So keep all your eggs warm, Buffy, because we love you. And our eggs hatch into chicks. Look at those faces. Here, Chicky, you're just so soft and adorable. Look at those intent faces. Here's Sophie, our cute little baby goat. Here's Sophie nursing from her mom. Here's our natural water purification pond, many kinds of plants. The children are learning how plants alone purify the water. Nothing goes in, nothing goes out. Scientific observation of our pond, you see no pump. Here are some of our beautiful flowering water plants. Our Freddy the Frog, he eats only insects and plants. And so does our fish Goldie. Nothing goes into this. We're moving into solar cooking now. Here's our history of solar cooking. Look at our solar cooker made with recycled pop bottles. Here's our box cooker on the left. Here are fresh onions from our garden for cooking. Here's some solar cooked zucchini. Kids, look at their faces. They just love how it smells. They learn how to serve each other with good manners. And food is really best when you grow it yourself. Look at that face from our fresh garden melon. So according to the kids, it's two thumbs up for gardening. So let's look at a summary of the values for which Global Seed stands while you're learning all these skills. Because there are global solutions to all problems with water, food, and education with love is the key. So let us start together, one child at a time. Here's our mission, that we are here to bring hope and solutions to our children with a sense of joy, beauty, and wonder. We're here to teach compassion with a sense of mutual responsibility. And we're here to speak only love in a concert of voices. And we are here to help our own children light their way to their own futures. Please join us as we work together for our children and for our earth. Because where flowers bloom, so does harmony and love.
Like everything that's really important in life, I think it comes from your own experience. And I'd like to share with you, if I may, for a minute, the three things that I feel like that led me to be doing this whole Global Seed Sustainable Environment Educational Project. First, I was born in a ranching family from the high country of New Mexico, the High Continental Divide, where my grandparents on both sides and my parents were ranchers, where there was no running water, no electricity, and if you wanted something, you had to grow and make it yourself with all kinds of hard work and ingenuity. And so I feel like that the wonderful respect that I had for all the integrity and the hard work of everybody in my family, and that wonderful way of life that helped me to see the incredible beauty and the interconnectedness of everything in nature was very, very important for me beginning this whole series of lessons, which we're calling an Urban Homestead Sustainable Environment Education Demonstration. The second thing that really affected me is that my husband, who also grew up in a sustainable farming family in Ohio, with his business, we traveled internationally a great deal with our children, and I met people from every culture, every race, and every religion around our whole planet, and saw that we really are all one family. I saw a lot of poverty, a lot of beauty around our whole planet, and that everybody is all interconnected, and that we are all responsible for each other. The third thing that I feel like that really affected me in kind of a backward way, and see what you think, is that in 1991 I had a very horrible car wreck where I had a closed head injury with two big blobs of bleeding in my brain, and I clinically died. I was in a coma. I was aphasic. I couldn't walk, couldn't talk, couldn't read, couldn't write. And it just so happened that at that point where I was with my graduate teaching assistantship, miraculously, I was allowed to do a little farming garden area that I had to set up everything all by myself, and there were no students for 6 months. So for 6 months, I was double digging out in that field all by myself, giving myself holistic cross-crawl patterning therapy with good food, good exercise, and I recovered. And I think it is a miracle that it has a lot to do with having all this farming, and also that I had a very profound near-death experience that really colored the rest of my life. As I finished up my doctorate in multicultural international education, Montessori and sustainability, and then a master's in hospital chaplain working with a children's bereavement program. So those three things really came together to help me to be able to do what I'm doing with Global Seed. And I know in your own life, it's the experiences that we have, isn't it, that just help us to be able to find our life's work.